Alright, so we're going to continue running G13 as best I can. I have lots of stuff. I don't need defense guidebook. I don't know how to use defense. I don't need to learn how to explore because I don't explore, and I'm not going to explore anytime soon, so I don't need that. So, I mean, of course, you guys can read all those books, and that's all well and good. If you don't know something fully, if I don't understand it because I talk too fast or something like that. I'll move my stuff around. Okay, now I got my sword. And I kind of wish I had another sword. Anyway, we're going to go run the next mission. So, next mission quest is Horatio's Dagger. So, we need to go talk to Marlow. Talk to... That's not the Avon Feather. We use the Avon Feather and teleport to Avon. Talk to Marlow. New guild. New people. Problems. Okay, it talks about how Shakespeare was unlikely and rats because of this flute. It's like the one guy who led children different places. I don't know. You can read all this more in depth. And I'm just going to continue until I do that. So now let's go talk to Fergus in Bangor. But you know what's kind of funny? I have to wait 5 minutes to... Wait, hold on. Yeah, I have to wait 4 minutes until I can do that again. So, I'm gonna stop recording now and come back in 4 minutes and we'll go talk to Fergus. Alright. Okay, so here we are. 4 minutes later, I'm under the Avon Arch, which, if you remember back when I first started making this video, was the login screen. Now it's not that, it's Belvast, new island for G15. But anyway, so we're gonna go to our last location the Avon Feather was used, which was Tyrconnell. And now we're back at Tyrconnell, we're gonna talk to Fergus, who's down here. We're gonna walk there, because my thoroughbred is expired. I don't have any pets on this account anymore. So, can they even talk about special tabs really useful? I don't know. I think that might require premium service, I'm not sure, but since I'm under total level 30, I still have the beginner service. Oh, total level 100 now. Sorry. My bad. Forgot about that. Oh, also, beginner levels can also rebirth every day. I forgot to mention that in the rebirth thing. Now we're talking to Fergus about making a dagger for the play. And he told us to go run Seer Dungeon. Fergus's large nail. And a red ring and the goddess. Oh, wait. Did that red ring and goddess go to? Oh, it goes right to Seer. So we're just going to use that and be lazy. Yay. Now we're at Seer. Yay. Fancy. If you didn't know, just so in case something weird happens, you don't have the red ring or you used it, you don't know how to get back there. Here's the map. Right there is where Fergus's shop was. All they do is walk up here, past this path, around this hill. And here's your dungeon. And you walk in this big cave with the scary looking trees. And you are there. So, to run this dungeon that Furious wants us to run, we're going to throw down the nails on the altar. And we're going to run this dungeon. Alright, so as I was saying, beginner level, under total level 100, can rebirth every day, every 24 hours. I forgot to mention that. So you can actually get AP pretty quickly. Wow, these are boss to me. It's pretty intense. But I can still almost beat them one combo. Windmill. Oh, wow, my windmill skill is really, really small, so I didn't even hit him. So you're using defense and smash counter defense, and you just canceled it. But I smashed him anyway. So I got some gold, a potion, I'm gonna hit this goblin. Should be easier to finish off because I windmilled him before. So I'm gonna hit him and use defense. He's gonna come up and hit me, and I'm gonna hit him back. That's how defense works. Just a refresher for all you guys. Beginner levels can rebirth every day, but you would get up to more than 100 a lot quicker that way. Just a warning. You won't have the free service or any free goodies. Think if I smash these guys, I might be able to kill in one hit. Nope. Alright, well, I'm gonna windmill him, because he's using smash. And windmill can counter smash if you use it the right time. So he's most likely using counter because he's standing still. I'm going to windmill him again. Yeah. I want to get my windmill experience up so I can rank it up. That's my plan anyway. Yeah, I got that guy. Now I got some great town rats. Bam. There we go. Kill that one too. I just think about it. What to talk about? I don't really know. But, you know, dungeon running is pretty key to tutorials. Just a warning, everyone. Like, he wanted me to run this dungeon for him, so I'm doing it. And then it's gonna... Okay, I'm pretty sure I remember this right. He dropped his hammer when he fought the boss. So we have to go get it back for him. And that's basically that. And then he'll make a dagger for the play. The Shakespeare play that we're running through. And helping Shakespeare put on. Alright. And then... Got M as your map. Seer Dungeon does not reveal the map right away. You have to actually walk to places for it to be there. So, yep. There's that. Master breaks video in the parts pane, how long this dungeon is. If you have pets, you can summon a pet and run a lot faster. And I'm going to laugh if this hallway is not where I'm supposed to go. But I think I picked up all the keys, right? Maybe I didn't have enough inventory for one. I don't know. Let's go through my inventory, throw out any stuff. I really don't need sketch paper. Pretty sure it's easy to buy. I don't think I need these either. These small gems. The red ones sell for like 20 or something. So I'll keep those. They're somewhat useful. My wizard hat. Cool little pointy wizard hat. Alright, so this is a really, really long hallway. You can see on the map up there, that's where I started, and I'm here, I was over there, and yeah, so I really hope there's something at the end of this hallway. If not, you guys will know that dungeon's gonna be very long if you're going on the wrong hallways. I think I saw a room. Oh, yep, there's a room right there. Wow, this is a very, very long hallway. Whoa. Pretty intense. Now we have to fight. Oh, two rooms. We got two rooms here. I have to backtrack down that really long hallway. So. Oh, there's the boss key. Wow. That's a short dungeon then. Guess I won't have to. But I don't have any inventory space for it. So I'll have to clean out more stuff. Or at least organize it better. Do you know this guy? There we go. Okay, I don't know if you guys noticed that. But I was able to get 4 combos out of my 3 combo sword. I'll explain that at a later date, but basically if you pause a certain amount of time after each swing, the knockdown gauge, as you saw on the goblin here, I'll show you it on this guy. That gauge right there, it'll go down. And if you wait for it to go down enough, sometimes it'll hit you. But if you wait too long, but if you wait for it to go down enough, you'll get another hit in while you're still stunned. Every weapon has a different stun time, and depending on how fast it is, it'll have a higher or lower stun time. If it's a fast weapon, it'll have very low stun time. If it's a slow weapon, it'll have a longer stun time. So I'm waiting about just a little bit of time after each swing, and that allowed me to hit 4 times. So I can go back down that hallway. And that technique is much easier with slower weapons, like if you get a mace or a warhammer, or even like the bigger swords, like a broadsword or a war sword or something. They're slow and they only have 2-hit combos, but if you wait just a little bit, you'll be able to get a 3-hit combo out of them, which can help you do more damage to an enemy. So it's very useful. However, it's very, very difficult to do with daggers, which are really fast, and like knuckles, I'm pretty sure, are also very fast. So they're very difficult to pull that off of, especially if you have any lag whatsoever. It's going to be definitely very, very difficult. Alright, so now for the golem. It's very useful to have the magic skill for the golem of firebolt, and then you can use counter and firebolt together. to help you defeat a golem. Otherwise, it's gonna be kind of tough, as you probably see here. But what you do is you load a firebolt and hit the golem and immediately load counter. Wait for it to hit you and counter, and then load another firebolt. You continue that process until it basically kills itself by hitting your counter so many times. And the firebolt will also do some damage. So that's a very simple, easy golem technique to defeat golems in particular, just because of the way golems work. Yeah, and depending on what the golem does, he'll use different moves, and I'll try to point that out, but I think we're going to see a mini show of Fergus here first. 5 days ago, when Fergus lost his hammer. So he's running to see your dungeon with his blacksmith hammer right there, which I think are awesome weapons. Cool hammer like that. And he's talking about house calls. And then he sees the golem, and he runs away and drops his hammer. And trips. Yep. Well, that's Fergus for you. Oh, I should probably equip a title. Let's see here. I can get titles. I think either Reborn, the Adult, the All Knowing. That's from being really old. And they give lots of intelligence because you're old and you're smart, apparently. I'm going to use Reborn, you know, good overall title. So this is a small golem. But it's still pretty high level to me, so I'm gonna open up with a. Actually, no, because I'm gonna try that three combo thing. Oh, I only did three hits. Oh well. So I load counter. It's not doing anything. It's probably also in counter, or it could be in windmill. Golems have windmill, so I'm just gonna load windmill and sit here and do that. Interesting thing about windmill is that if you click outside and then pull it into your radius, it'll spam that message and you'll nearly automatically use windmill when an enemy gets close enough to you. Now, since that golem was moving fairly slow, it's using defense, so I'm gonna smash it. And that's good. And then now it's waiting to skill, so I'm gonna send the windmill again. I'm gonna do that, drag it in. So it does it really fast. So if you have pretty good no lag, you will it'll execute windmill right when an enemy gets close enough to you. I'm loading defense, and it looks like it has the defense, so I'm going to hit it with smash, because, oh, but it canceled using normal attack on me. Now I see that normal attack can counter smash. I'm going to go to a normal attack, press counter. Now, it's probably either in windmill or counter, but it canceled the skill and just hit me, so I'm going to use defense. And they have lots of health. This is just small golem. Bigger ones give you much more trouble. Definitely, if you run Seer Normal, or even Seer Beginner, has a harder golem. But I got Fergus's hammer and a title, the Golem Slayer. I just changed my title, so I probably will get it. But the Golem Slayer gives a decent amount of strength, dex, and HP. I'm not so good for mages because it minuses the MP, but that's good stuff. So I'm gonna quit the video here. It's already out of time. Make sure to grab your loot from the chest. We got some gold, some HP potions, some boots we don't have room for. I'm gonna move that inventory out of the way. And these boots are just about the same as the other ones, but I believe they're pretty expensive, so you can sell them. Oh, but they're enchanted. Fox Tamers, which gives no levels over 8, minimum damage 2 increase. So you can wear those, get a little more minimum damage from above 8. But for now, I'll see you guys later.